Father, we just come to you. Father, we just thank you for keeping us safe during Carnival, especially with all the men who were trying to eat my beautiful fiance for lunch. I could handle it, though. Please help her to turn towards you and to not decide to leave me when she comes to America. And Father, we just please help my hip. I've been having problems lately. And I'm not sleeping as well as I used to, and I'm still tired from Carnival, Father Weegis. My ankle is not as flexible as it used to be, and Father Weegis, about my hair. If you could see it, that my hair would look good 1 or 2 days a week, I'd be very grateful, because you've always blessed me, Father Weegis. And what do you say, Anna?
Let's go eat.
No, may the force be with you.
She says, may the force be
yes!
with you.
Yes! That's the funny part.
I miss that.
You're useless.
Oh, sure, I can have a baby after 45. Let me throw these chicken bones.
I never thought I'd have a blonde American wife. But when I brought you that ranch dressing, I knew I'd be your dipping sauce for life. I booked a dream vacation on a tropical isle. I only wanted to bone. Oh, how could I have known that I'd wind up knocked up and really pissed? Oh, love in paradise. We're planting a banana tree. Love in paradise. Have you heard of polyamory? I swear that I can see forever in your giant dick. Love in paradise.
It's the size of my arm.
Fade it, Gary. Wonderful. It, Gary.
I tried to give you one thing.
She said, may the force be with you?
Yes.
I was taking notes. I wasn't even watching on quick speed.
Well, you missed it.
She did not say
that. She said, may the force be with you.
No, she didn't.
I went.
No, she didn't.
She did. No, sorry. May the force be with us. She said, may the force
be
with us.
I am so sorry. I fucked that up. But I am gobsmacked.
Apologize
right now
to our audience, not just to me. Like, I let you hit the punchline. And you belly flopped. Wow. That was the best line of the episode.
I got up at one part while I was gone to just refill my coffee, and I bet that was it. It was during
now,
this segment.
And now I don't have, and now I'm like Cow Patty. How can I trust you? How can I trust you that you're actually, following along with the show?
I don't blame you.
You're a failure today.
I have failed today. I admit it. I have failed today.
It's a good way for me to start. Yo, this is lip. This is lip.
I'm going to have to watch that again.
It was incredible. And she said it. She was looking around while he was praying, too. She's just looking around the church. I love it that they're in a church. Bitches, like, completely shoulder covered.
Not even.
Boobs are hanging out.
Yeah.
I respect it.
Respect.
Although, he could have worn long pants to a church.
He looked ridiculous in that. You know what that shirt he wore? It was kind of that. It didn't look like a hyper color shirt, but you know how it kind of like this ombre.
Yeah,
it looked just like the shirt that my dad's second wife Brenda got me from the buckle.
Oh, yeah.
When she found out I was gay and I came home, she got me the shirt that had blue flames on it.
His shirt, his clothing is clothing where I just came out.
It is
very clothing for a gay who just came out at 24.
A gay who doesn't live in a big city.
Yes. He had, and you know what it is when I like it? Mm-hmm. When I go, ooh, that's interesting choice. I still like his asymmetric sweater that he wore. That was the best thing. Everything else is very gay adjacent.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, that kind of ombre thing was awful. But no, he...
Wow, may the force be with... Sorry, I'm still taking that in. I am so sorry.
She's just looking around at the church while he's Father Ouija sing, and Anna doesn't realize my faith is very important to me. And this is another, the storytelling on this season is not consistent.
Because I agree with that.
If anything, that thing about faith would have been brought up way before now.
I feel like, too.
I've got to say, this is a failure. We're like thrown new storylines. You don't do that in episode 9.
No.
Yo, this is episode 9, Lip. I'm going to call this Papa Don't Preach.
Yeah, because you don't have the title. Because I'm in trouble deep. Papa Don't Preach.
Or maybe Like a Prayer. I don't know. It's not consistent. They did Mama Said Knock You Out last week. I was thinking, have they been doing rap songs? But I think it's been inconsistent. They've been titles of songs.
It's been inconsistent. Yeah, because we don't know what the title is yet.
We're doing this a little earlier.
Which, by the way, happy Pride, everybody.
Happy Pride, everybody.
We're all doing this on a Sunday. We went and had celebrated Gay Pride last night. Well, you saw Bernadette Peters on Friday.
I saw Bernadette Peters on Friday and Renee Fleming on Saturday.
We both saw Renee Fleming last night. And Rufus Wainwright was there, and I just saw Rufus Wainwright last weekend at Pride. So we just...
That's how I celebrate Pride.
That's how we celebrate
Going
Pride.
To see divas.
And queening out.
Yeah. That was... My weekend was gayer than, like, butt sex and a sling at Slammers.
Boy, that's true. Loaded! And we saw Merle Dandridge, our new obsession.
That's true!
Oh,
I loved her!
I would join that fan club.
That's a step too far.
Okay.
No one has fan clubs anymore.
They don't?
No. If you are, you're an incel. You just like someone.
Remind me not to let you check my emails.
I'm sure your email is just full of so-and-so's fan clubs. It's like when I was in the Tori Amos thing for a while when I was part of the Tory Tory story or whatever it was, Tory files
themselves, and then they lost because they were just depressed.
I had to leave because it was just a little too intense.
It's just a lot.
I always join these kind of groups, and then I get the email. But every time I'm in a fan club, it's like when I fucked that guy who was the president of the Los Angeles fans of Patti LaBelle.
What? Hold on.
And he wouldn't.
What?
He wouldn't shut up about Patti LaBelle, and I'm like, this isn't going to work.
Wait a minute. You met him like on Grindr or whatever, or Scruff or something?
Yeah, something like that. It wasn't in his profile.
He came over or whatever, and y'all fucked, and then post-coitus, he starts talking about Patti LaBelle?
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, it's not good pillow talk.
Did you fuck that guy that's in that pie video? That Patty!
No.
I love that guy.
No, this guy was
gay.
This guy was a lot weirder. There wasn't a second encounter. Let's just say that. As soon as he started telling me about the Patti LaBelle fan club.
Did he have a nice dick?
It was okay.
Oh, there you go. That's why
I probably would have given him a 7 or 8 and said, would fuck again. Oh. But the Patti LaBelle stuff just took me out because it's not that I have a problem with someone who's a fan. I have a problem with someone who's a president and who is part of the administration of a fan club.
That's a lot.
I feel like that's a part of like daily work.
And you want him to favor your sweet potato pie over Patty's
exactly.
sweet potato pie. Yeah.
Exactly.
That's what you want.
Yeah. And he would choose Patty's every time.
He would choose
And that's
Patty's.
That's not acceptable.
You can get it at Walmart, apparently. I've never had it. I don't love sweet potato pie like everybody, but I didn't grow up with
it. I prefer pumpkin.
There we go.
Yeah.
Think about the trajectory of where we just went.
I don't know.
Turn on timing.
Oh, yeah. We need it.
Where we just went in the last 5 minutes from completely failing and dropping
the
ball.
May the force be with us, timing.
To now back to... You don't prefer sweet potato pie. You prefer pumpkin.
Riveting. Riveting.
Riveting.
Riveting. Y'all, I believe we have 3 more episodes of Lip.
While we're dragging people through our muck, do we have any announcements that we do need to... I feel like we do need to talk about the YouTube Live.
It's just been out yesterday, but we have an episode 1 of our coffee date with Kim and Kyle.
Yeah.
From 90 Day Fiancé, Cray Cray is out. Episode 2 will be out this evening. We're recording it on Monday. It'll come out.
We're recording this on Monday. Yeah. Yeah, it'll be at it's only one part of the 90 Day this week for us. So our part, I think part one is on our feed.
And part two
is on their feed. So normally you get a Sunday night drop and then a Monday night drop. You're only going to get a Sunday night drop.
And there's no intimate portrait because Kim and Kyle, y'all, they don't show
their
faces.
They don't do video.
Yeah.
We begged them.
They said no.
I said, Kim, look, you have this beautiful, beautiful orange hair. And Kyle, look. I think it's great that you have to show your third nipple. I think he should. Poodle would have taken his shirt off too.
I would have.
Anyway, we
try. I feel like there's something else. Let me look at
I was going to say the YouTube Live for the people on Reality Gaze Plus on the $15
Sunday, not the final Sunday, because I'm in South Carolina and I'm worried
but
about
when
tech.
This airs. It'll be then on right
when this airs.
It'll be on the,
it airs
coming
Monday.
Sunday. So this airs on Monday, and then the next Sunday will be,
June 18th.
Poodle's going to South Carolina. He's too scared that Mother Poodle is going to come in. I'm all for it. I would love for Mother Poodle to come.
I don't
it's like.
When
remember when Aunt Peggy came into a YouTube Live?
I don't love chaos like that.
Oh, we loved
like
it.
You do. And we're taking a week off the week of July 4th. They're also going to be... In the following week of that, there are going to be some special guests I'm in contact because you're getting a new face on. You're going to look like the Elephant Man for a while.
I'm getting my neck done, my jawline.
And
so.
he's out of the show because I decided no one needs to see that.
Actually, I have a fellow friend who's had it done and said, you're too gay when you talk. You'll pop your stitches. So you have to wait. So I'm going to be recouping at home with my mother. She's very excited. I've already bought her a type of overhead lamp like from Amazon. Actually, I got this one really cheap on Nomaza.
And
it's an overhead lamp that goes over your head just like she has at home so that way she can see for her knitting.
Is she sleeping in your bed?
I told her she could. I wouldn't care. No one else is. But... she said, I don't know. We'll see. I'm fine on the couch, baby. But she is very excited. She has already sent me some yarn. She wants me to start knitting. We're going to knit, and we're going to go through. I digitized all of our family photos. And she said, well, I can go through and tell you what all of them are.
While you're knitting.
You can name them.
While you're knitting, why don't you sew up your asshole?
I should, because no one's going to use it
anymore. No. Yeah, and her being out here for two weeks is not going to be helpful for that.
No, so. It's actually only a week, but still, I'm kind of fine with it. No one needs to use this asshole. The asshole doesn't be used. Maybe I'll be like Jasmine. It'll be like re-virginized.
Not yours.
Well, but so anyway.
Anyway, I think we can move on. Below Deck Down Under season 2 has been announced for July 17th. It's fantastic.
Really?
Yeah.
Good.
Really hot crew. Looks like a female chef who knows what she's doing.
I can't say who, but it's very much some really a very direct inside information that I got that this season of Below Deck Sailing Yacht, this person told me we haven't even seen craziness yet. It's about to begin.
Good.
Which it's already been good. I think it's been a really good season.
It has been a good season.
BDSM.
So, far.
So if you're not caught up on Below Deck Sailing Yacht, we recommend.
People are always asking.
RG recommends. Ooh,
people are.
I love that.
People are asking us shows to watch. I know, and you need to chill the fuck out.
Excited to be here.
So
I had such a good time with you last night at Renee. We've been friends for almost 20 years, and I love that we're in the Dorothy Chandler Pavilion. I only saw one person because I'm not as gay as you, but that's not true. You're more opera gay. But I love that we live in this city with thousands of people, and we just saw people we knew the whole night.
Yeah, it was fun.
We've really slept with a lot of people.
I to be fair, most of the people I saw were music friends and music associated people.
Wouldn't stop you before. late night rehearsal.
I did see.
One of them was real
cute. I did see a former paramour.
Oh, you mentioned that to me.
Yeah, but because I didn't say hello. Sometimes I don't. You don't say hello.
It was really nice.
We made eyes at one another in the bathroom. We thought it was better not to.
Oh, that's why I went to pee later, and I saw you washing your hands, and I said something. You did, and when I said it, you jumped like someone put a firecracker under your ass.
Yeah,
you didn't thought it was him.
Wanted to keep a low profile.
I am that person. If you want to do a low profile, I'll jump.
You're not the one to call.
Hey, Jaybird, how you doing?
Yeah, hopefully he just. Let me have that credit card and isn't going to. He did cut it off about a year later, but
slow.
Can we start with Cal Patty and Juan?
Oh God, talk about Juan Hanks. Oh God. Oh, family got my auntie. Not so funny because my mom died.
Bless his heart. I'm looking forward to never seeing them again and never hearing that bad impression.
Oh, Juan Hanks is sticking around. Get ready. Oh, get ready.
Think he looks like him.
It's going to be like your Stephanie from Michigan Cuckoo. It's going to live on for at least another 6 months.
Oh, I had a hard time letting that one go.
You did. We would even do non-90 day shows. We would be doing something like Riverdale.
And
you go, Archie, and it's Cuckoo.
Oh, Cuckoo. God, what a mess. I want to also say, if you're cooking hamburgers, don't press your burgers. Stop that.
No, you can press them in the middle before you cook them.
Yes, but you're just putting the juice, you're just like squeezing the juice out of your burger. There'll be hockey pucks. Stop pressing your burgers.
There's only one time
with a spatula.
You squeeze poodle's patty to get the juice out, and it's not when you're cooking meat.
True. This is post Megan conversation where I brought up last week, and
I was gonna have you bring it up because
I've been thinking about it because I've been thinking about it a lot. I feel like he is not being actually transparent on this storyline and on this encounter with this woman and why it happened. I'm of two minds here. Cal Patty needs to. You can choose one or the other. You can choose to believe him and not this woman, or you can choose to believe the woman and that's it. There is nothing in the middle here. It's either, sadly, when you're like Cal Patty and you live in a town of 8,000 people and it just smells like shit all the time.
Not 8,000, that's a big town. I mean, it's like 800. Lone Grove's only 2,000. It's like
8,000 people is not a big town, sweetie.
It is. Oh my God, that's like... I mean, that's bigger than Duncan.
I don't
that's
know where
that is.
That's
a very big... Duncan, that's where Halliburton was, where Ron Howard's from.
Oh.
Where I used to go to the orthodontist, Dr. Hall. Anyway, 8,000's a lot of people.
Okay, regardless.
You would have two elementary schools at that one, and that was big time. We only had one.
Regardless, I think this is a situation where she needs to say, and maybe it's been there, and maybe it's because the cameras are there, and maybe they're just trying to cock tease us. But I want a situation where she says, tell me everything. And if he lays it all out and then he says, this is what happened. This woman thought we're more. And I have to be flirty to get tips like this. I'm a literal cruise ship bartender. It not hot when you're married.
Is he
engaged?
Working?
That's the thing I wonder. That's why I think this might be fraudacity, because if I was having another baby, I'm like, give me money.
So it's interesting. You said she has one or two choices. I don't think she has a choice anymore.
Yeah.
You decided to have a baby with this person. If that's his job, literally it's like saying, at least the way they're treating the storyline, it's that let's say she married someone who, or she had a baby with someone who's an escort.
Yeah.
And that is their sole income. And she says, hey, I need you to stop escorting, but I'm not working, so I need you to support our family.
And that's an extreme form of what we're talking about.
Build our apartment complex.
Right.
But I'm using that, but even in extreme form, I wouldn't feel sympathy for her.
She frustrates the shit out of me.
I'm like, he's got to flirt with people on a cruise ship. And honestly, I kind of feel like, look, Is he cheating? Probably.
That's
he works
kinda,
on a cruise ship,
that's
but it doesn't
where
matter.
I am. That's, I find
I don't think it matters.
I totally agree. And I think she needs to either trust him completely and say, I trust you, and then get her heart broken, and little gay porn twins will have a problem with that, and they'll miss him too. But you can't have it both ways. You can't say, I trust you, and then consistently bring up this to where he has to kind of go, yeah, I promise I didn't do it, again and again and again.
Well, you know, like Miss Mai says, when people show you who you are, believe them. How did she meet him?
Exactly.
She met him. Exactly.
She fucked around. She fucked around on a cruise with him.
She fucked around on a cruise, and that's how they met. So you knew that, and yet you now decided you want to get married to him. Great. You decided you want to have a baby. Great.
You knew who he was.
You want him to completely walk away from his income. And honestly, I feel like, honey, you need to let him cheat on you while he's on this cruise ship, because he's going to have to come fucking live in cow patty land, and he's going to hate that.
100% right there. Ding, ding, ding.
His mother already died from COVID. He has no father. He's leaving all of this wonderful family. He's coming to live in cow shitville. Give him this.
You need to let him be knee-deep in cruise ship pussy.
Yes.
And knee-deep yes. in Midwest, slutty, like, drunk girl pussy.
Because he's getting the shit into the stick when he comes here.
Literally. I side with you 100% here, and that solves my problem of the 100% trust. Because I can't take another episode of... Did it happen? Did it not happen? I don't care. It's irrelevant at this point.
Yeah.
That's how I feel. Anyway, I find this situation frustrating, and I only feel bad for him.
I only feel bad for him, too. And I feel worse than that. His family seems lovely. They seem so fun. You know,
kiss.
Bethel, Beth. Because his aunts are there. Because, yeah, y'all, his dad died when he was younger. His mom just died of COVID.
And the mom's dying wish was that he marry Jessica.
Yes. So he's whether he wants to marry her now, because he says, and I understand this, like, that was heartbreaking when my ex and I broke up, because I thought, okay, at least my dad met the person I'm going to be with for So that is a heart. But in the scoop, I want to tell one, that doesn't really fucking matter. Just be happy. I was really upset at the time, but I'm like, who gives a fucking shit? Y'all, if your parent doesn't know, that's not a reason to stay with someone.
Agree.
And so, but I understand though but I bring that up because I think because of that, he is going to deal with more bullshit from her.
Oh, yeah.
Than he normally would with someone.
Yeah, totally agree.
And I bet that's what led to him wanting to have a kid with her.
Yeah, that may be true.
It's confusing. One time they said they planned to have this kid, and then another time they said it happened.
Well, here are the clues that we've been given. Juan said she had,
I feel like I
quote,
should do music when you do ding ding
right. These are the facts of the case. Juan said she had baby fever and stopped. We stopped using now. Both of these people participated in making a baby.
I would hope.
Now,
I've tried to make one by myself. It never works.
But it did sound like, and I don't know if this was the case, he is saying that it initiated with her. I don't know if I was Juan, if I would be on a cruise ship, I don't know if I would want to start having a child so quickly.
It does feel a little bit like she was like, lock his number, lock him on your uterus. Yep. That was a little Darcy and Stace there.
Yeah. It's so interesting how I've turned from her, because she just gets on my fucking nerves. Everything
I have no opinion on her, really.
Yeah. I feel like, I think I mentioned you before we started, I feel like if she was a regular and like a normal 90 day or a B90, she would be hated. I just think she's a pretty blonde girl who, I think she would be universally reviled.
Wow.
I just went there. So y'all, the family's lovely. One of the uncles says, thank God for the meat.
And
been there.
And they're at this beautiful...
Jessica and Juan go on this date. It's really pretty, actually.
Beautiful views. And then she's basically... She brings up him going back to cruises, and she says, being in situations where girls want the cute cruise boy, but it always feels like this... It always feels a little like... She fucked the help, and it feels like that to me when she talks about it.
I get that.
And she's like, it's easy to do something and get away with it. If someone said that to me, I would say, well, here's the thing. Do you trust me or you don't? Now, I don't think he's the kind to get that way.
No, Juan Hanks is too Juan Hanks.
Yeah.
He's not confrontational.
He's a nice guy.
Oh, where you are? Jessica.
That's the last time
this episode. I will not have you censor my Juan Hanks. Will not have you.
Anyway.
Not after Stephanie Cuckoo.
He denies it and says, he said, I didn't do anything with her. And she said, did you know you were with someone? He's like, well, I'm very quiet about my personal life. Y'all, a bartender is quiet about their personal life.
I don't want to know if a go-go dancer has a husband.
If any of you have been a bartender, you know that it's part of the fantasy that you're flirting. And I think part of her knows this, but it's...
Not 100% of her knows this.
And
she's asking him to do something.
Yeah.
That is not who he is.
He's like 1/10 of a club promoter, y'all.
Yes. But when he says, I don't believe him when he says, I didn't realize that woman that keeps calling, I didn't realize she was hitting on
me.
Disagree. Bullshit.
Yeah, you did.
You knew. That's where I started to go, maybe he did dick her down. But who cares?
I believe he did. I believe he probably
Most men do cheat, so they probably did.
Here we go.
But who cares?
Now,
he's going to Cow Patty Town.
I will say, she said, if you're asked whether you have a girlfriend, you kind of need to say yes. And he goes, which means less money.
So I'll take the trade-off. And I went, then you can't hound him for supporting your kid when he's making less tips.
Because guess what? Your ex-husband isn't going to give that new baby a dime.
No.
So, and I guarantee you, the custody agreement and the new alimony agreement that he's paying you is going to get messy.
Sissy Mary, I want to know her job. If she has one.
Yeah. I find...
It's not that expensive, probably, live in Cow Patty Town.
The whole idea of someone quitting a job and finding a business of building apartments, which is going to take more money in at the beginning than you'll make... is absolutely financially absurd. So that's why I think it's either fraudacity or she's a moron.
She's not, fraudacity or she's not in reality.
It's that one or the other. That's where I am.
Maybe little David's taken all of her brain power. Yeah, when they said...
David's been born.
When they say, oh, and we have a girl, we're going to... I'm like, well, spoiler alert, you ain't having... Not naming her after mom. Why didn't you name her after
your
dad?
You could have been Davida or Davina.
Maybe his dad's name was David.
Yeah, probably.
Hopefully.
At least it's not... It's a lot less gay porny.
No, that's not a gay porn name. No.
Yeah.
We need to take a break, everybody. We're going to be right
back.
Is
it that long? Oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. We've gone 27 minutes.
Jesus.
We talked forever at the first.
Yes, me. My hair's not right.
Jesus, help my hair.
Okay. It doesn't really, it's not a style. He said, it's that unkempt look. Unkept, as he said. And the phrase is unkempt.
Unkempt.
You didn't know
what
it did, right?
I don't know what I said. Probably unkempt.
Unkempt.
Well, look at that.
Yeah.
Sounds very German.
I don't know.
Wait, I don't want to look it up.
I don't know the etymology.
So here's the deal. Is there more to Matthew than we know?
I think there's less.
Okay. I don't know. I don't think he's a little gay or anything, but something's up. Like the hair, the church thing.
I just think he's really fastidious. Some straight men are like that.
But I mean, the fact that he's like, and the way like...
He's peculiar.
It's not a gay thing. It's not at all. I shouldn't say that. But there's something, I just feel like there's something about Matthew we don't know. And he's presented, this is what it is. It has nothing to do with sexuality actually at all. It's, but I feel like he's hiding something. And watching this, I don't have any, it's more of a feeling, but I feel like, not that he's this terrible person, but I just feel like the really goody two shoes, fun Instagram, the being concerned with his hair, the God thing. I just feel like it's like you're either you feel like a piece of shit in the world or you're hiding something to make yourself feel
better. I think it's the cameras trying to present a really what he winds up doing is going overboard to present himself as someone who is quirky and a good boy on camera. That's what it feels like. That's what it feels fake.
So when someone feels this performative, I'm a good boy, I really think, well, how bad are you?
What's wrong?
What's there?
Yeah, I agree. I don't know if there's enough of a bad boy in there, though. I think
you would know.
Yeah. He doesn't have that look about him.
You brought out
Trust
many.
Me. And I will say, the hair that he's trying to get is simple pomade. I don't know why...
I knew you related because y'all Poodle has spent.
I've spent a lot of time on my hair.
His hair,
but I've never gone.
Your hair looks better. I will say his hair actually looked the best when they got out of the pool.
Agree.
He actually, I think, needs less. Stuff
when
in
straight
it.
Men work really hard, it's kind of sad. You don't need straight men. You can go through your lives. I'm all eight of you who are listening. You don't have to have good hair. If you do have good hair, it's even hotter when you don't do a lot with it.
Me think maybe you bit a little bit of projection onto that statement.
Maybe. But what I'm saying, gay men, gay hair is different. Gay hair, that's all we have. Some gay men listening who are bald, they're like, is that really that important? Yes.
I love a bald gay man. I prefer that. I love, you can grab
on. Wonder why.
It gives you something to grab onto.
No, the hair is something to grab onto.
No, I'm not. That's hard. No, like a bald head, it's just kind of like.
Has it always been that way for you?
I've liked bald-headed men for a long time, yeah. You date bald-headed men.
I have.
Yeah.
But I'm saying.
Those beads of sweat on the top of their head when they're working for
it. Why does this feel fetishizing?
No!
That's where it gets to fetishing for me.
I'm just saying I enjoy it. I like both things.
Okay.
I've been with men with hair and not hair.
But it's important that the hair be good when there's hair.
When there's hair, yeah. I think I think you're way more concerned about hair than I am.
Because
you... are way care more about your, like, that in a positive way. Like, you've
always... Don't
say
I care more about my appearance than you do, because that's a lie.
No. I'm not saying my appearance. I'm saying, like, because I remember we would be going out, and we would need to add 10 more minutes if your
hair would
need
to fix my hair.
Now, that said, your hair always looked really good.
Thank you. But I can do hair, but I'm saying for straight men, you're give it a pass.
No, I agree. I agree.
Sometimes straight men have naturally good hair. But when they work at it too hard, it's almost sadder. That's what I want to say.
Yeah, because they just don't need to.
Yeah. Anyway, y'all, she's basically, they're at this really interesting resort. And he's like, and she basically says, I've wanted to go to the U.S. since I was 4. I could get a better job and help my family. And I got lucky to find an American.
So this is kind of in this, you don't know if it's storytelling or not, but it does seem like she really loves him, but they really laid it on thick that she loves America a little more. I mean, he even asked her this whole line of,
what do you prefer? What do you like being more, being with me or being in America? And she went, well, I really want to be in the U.S., but I needed a reason. And I went, you didn't answer the question.
I actually think it's an unfair question.
It is an unfair question.
That would be saying to you or me, hey, what's more important to me? You're dating someone and they say, is it more important for you to be with me or is it more important for you to live your dream of being an artist?
Live my dream of being an artist.
Like that. That
is, oh, sorry. I shouldn't have said that.
But like, again, that's something you had.
I agree.
Way before this person even came
totally.
In. It has nothing to do with him.
It's an unfair question. It is a question that has been asked a lot.
A lot.
In 90 Day Universe. So.
Because again, in 90 Day, they want us to feel that love conquers all and love should be all.
And then they go to the church and the Father We Just prayer. And then she has the best line of the show, which you never heard.
I gotta watch that again.
And then he's like, you know, Anna, I got some unexpected news. He kind of talks like Father Poodle a little bit.
Sometimes
I got some unexpected news, friend. It's gonna take up to 2 years. She immediately dissolves into tears, and it did feel like, was she mourning her relationship?
Yeah.
Or now?
Yeah, it did feel a little that way.
Do I believe that he knew it was gonna take that long from the beginning? Yes.
Yeah.
Do I believe that he thinks he can't get a woman who looks like that? Yes. Is he correct? Yes. I don't know. I think there's something about him. I think this is the principle that we were talking about. It's what I called the Hazel principle from Tariq and Hazel. Mm-hmm. It is the idea of, does she love him? Yes. Does she want to go to America? Yes. And the both things are a Venn diagram that actually is a circle.
Can I say, though, I don't think that's a... I think there's better comparables in the 90 Day
Universe. You're right, probably.
Like, it's a little bit of an age difference, but if you think about, like...
Allah and Matt.
Allah and Matt. If you think about... But I was even thinking about, like, Michael and Juliana.
Yep.
And, or... what's her name and the guy from Florida who died, who didn't take a COVID? Who was
Jason and Cassia.
Jason and, when you think about both of those, are much more closer to comparables of beautiful women.
Jason and Cassia are closer. Although this guy's cuter than Jason.
He is, and much nicer guy. But what happened, those both relationships? They came over to the U.S. and they left
crumbled.
Those nerds, and they're dating really hot guys now.
I think I mentioned Tariq and Hazel because you can sense Hazel's part that she's really convinced herself that she loves Tariq.
Yes. And I want to say, y'all, it's a tale as old as time. A really hot young girl is going to want to date a really hot young guy.
That would be her first choice.
That's just the way. If we were all smarter when we were younger and had asses that bounced like new tennis balls fresh from a can, then Poodle would have married Sam Walton before he died.
True.
Like,
oh, God, that was the one that got away.
I know. Died of the same cancer my dad did.
Oof.
So, but literally, we would have made better choices.
Didn't we almost have it all?
Instead, we fucked around with people our age in our 20s. Ooh,
that family would have been rough, though.
That are also broke. Might as well just marry a Coke brother.
That's true.
And I wish I would
have. Have you seen the things from the Walmart Pride collection?
No.
Oh, it is amazing.
I'm so glad they have it, though. I wonder if they have it in Ardmore.
But you can tell it's Walmart because it's a little tweet. And it'll say, like, one of them was like, there was a TikTok someone sent me, and it was like pride, but it was shiplap. And I was like, don't you ever combine pride with farmhouse chic.
I actually think that where people are from, that's what we need. We need, no, because my dad's third life, she probably would have liked that. people that shop at the Buckle are going to want.
Yeah.
Are going to want shiplap pride.
But no, I get, if you look up.
It would bother me.
Walmart
too.
Pride TikTok. It's a guy doing it. He's a very famous TikToker. And he does like 5 out of 5 stars or 6 out of 5 stars. And there's just, it's weird. It's just
that.
So tweaked. And there's one, it's like pride or die or something like that.
Well, y'all, if y'all go to Walmart, even if you don't, if there's something that's inexpensive, buy a little bit of it because
I agree.
That shows them that you want to support, and they put it in the store next year.
I want to say too, I'm loving seeing in our Sissy Squad. That's our Facebook group.
We have fun
y'all.
In there.
I'm loving seeing people posting of going to Pride, both LGBT community members and allies.
We should talk about, we have a post in there for people that are going to Pride. Don't, it's a whole thread. If people are going to a Pride and you're looking to meet up with other sissies,
I wanted to make
Pride.
A post. I don't know if it has been done yet.
I think Jackie did.
Oh, good.
I saw it. Jackie made a post about it. So and I think it's pinned. We never talked about it.
I would highly encourage you guys, this, especially this Pride. One of the reasons we ask that if you're living under a rock is there's so many either intended legislation or just general perception of LGBT community members as, quote, groomers. And terms like that, terms like that are othering, and they're dangerous. And so if you have people in your family or friends who post things like groomers or freaks or things like that, my advice is to either engage with them or block them, because that's not something you can actively, you can see and just casually not have a problem with if you also support our community.
I mean, it's everywhere. I mean, it's horrible what's happened in Glendale. Yep. I have a friend who has put out his
and the Valley
Pride flag for three different times, and this one person keeps tearing it down. The week before, he was beat up.
Yep. So the LGBT
community.
It's not community,
just in red parts of the state.
No, it's everywhere.
What happens with this legislation? When legislation like this happens, then fucking trolls think that that means.
They think it's okay.
They are. They're given permission by our government.
But yeah, this. Would say if you're an ally and you think, and you've never been to a Pride, or you've just said, you know, I'll go, or I might not feel comfortable, I guarantee you this is the time to go. Because you're telling your friends, you're telling your family, and post pictures of you going.
Saying, that's what's actually more important, for you to go and for you to post on your social media.
Yeah.
For you to talk about what a fun experience you had. And I know that we're asking some of you to maybe put yourself in vulnerable situations, but anybody who's a minority, we have to have some people in the majority.
Yeah. Allyship helps more now than ever.
Yeah, it really makes a big difference.
Because you can communicate with the people who hate us a lot better than we can.
It's
sadly.
True, because your Aunt Doris might see that you say you're an ally, and she goes, oh, Jessica didn't know you were an ally. You know a bunch of homosexuals. And then you talk to Aunt Doris about homosexuals.
I don't know why an Aunt Doris would talk like that, but...
but still, that's how it happens.
An Aunt Shira, maybe.
Sure.
I don't know where we are. The only thing...
About her completely sobbing, and she's saying, are you serious? She starts crying, and then Matthew says this line, but don't we have a love that's worth fighting for?
She goes, huh?
Huh? Yeah. No, that's not more important than going to America.
What? I'm sorry. What did you say? I was thinking about my dreams dying. Going to Waffle House.
Yeah. It's already, when I saw the religion thing too, especially now that I know that she says, may the force be with you or with us.
it was a great moment. I snorted.
Y'all, we're going to have a values issue.
Oh, we are. It's going to be
a values issue. I'm calling it now. It's going to be another Michael and Julie. Y'all, she's going to get to the U.S., in 2 years,
good for her.
She's gonna find another hot
good
guy.
Good for
and
her.
Move on.
I also
and
need
Matthew's
to say,
gonna end up marrying that woman at church.
Yep. I also need to say that he looks positively exhausted.
Oh, he's so tired. He's so tired.
It's funny to me. He looks so tired still from carnival.
All right, let's
can we
go
talk
ahead.
About Carlentine, Carlentine, come on and ride, I'm a Model T. Carlentine, you're so pretty, though, oh, the wedding's off, oh no, Carlentine.
Ain't gonna get married today.
That's the washboard solo at the end.
Yeah, I got that. That's pretty good, actually. And it was a washboard. We used to have a washboard.
I think it got lost in the move.
Yeah.
I'm convinced there is a complete conspiracy with movers where a box just falls off the truck and they just split it in between the two of them or the four of them.
Who wants a Who wants a washboard and a broken bucket of lube?
It doesn't matter. What I'm saying
that's
is
what they, got.
They just choose a box and they just split it because everyone just says, oh, sometimes boxes get lost in the move. I think movers in this country are selling
the
merchandise that falls off trucks.
Opinions of Jake Anthony are not the opinions of reality gays. I believe in movers. Hashtag movers strong.
I'm not saying hashtag not all movers. I'm saying, I think it happens. It's happened to me every time I've moved.
Well, and that's fair because you have, anybody I know, you're really excellent at keeping track of everything and having it organized.
Right?
To move
Carlos
on.
Is meeting Michelle.
Like nothing happened.
He is emotionally drained and my heart is broken.
He is so fucking dramatic.
He's exhausting.
He's exhausting.
Yeah.
I think
Valentine
theory. Dodged a dramatic bullet.
I have a theory, and I was thinking about this. My picks for the next single life are Valentine. I'd love Valentine to be on the single life.
I'd love for him to be on single life.
I would love Lydia. I would love a Lydia season because that would be chaos.
I think she would be great on Single Life.
Yeah.
I actually think, even though he gets on my nerves, I think Carlos on Single Life would give us very Natalie vibes.
That would be almost too
but
chaotic.
It almost would be too much with Natalie. Y'all, yeah. Because Natalie's going to be on the Single Life
yeah.
again.
Yes, she is.
Natalie's going to be on the Single Life for us until she has Bibby. But even when she has baby, she'll probably still not get married. And then she'll say,
no.
I have baby. Will you marry me? And give me other baby.
I really
crib,
want...
Crib!
Crib!
Stop chasing me, Crib!
Crib, why are you here in Florida? Supposedly she's in the LA area now.
It looks like on social media, she's still dating that Josh.
I think they're doing it just for clout. He's a really bad clout chaser online.
God,
we follow him.
Dick, though. I bet it's nice.
So anyway, I also want, I really want Kalani because all the rumors are that
they broke up,
are
yeah.
that they are broken up. It may be too early for her to
I
date
would
again.
Love, I would love Kalani on the single life.
Yeah. And why not another Caesar season? I'm okay with that too.
No, we need Caesar and Natalie on the single life.
Yeah, that's what I really want, Lydia. I really want Valentine. Because these shows aren't about people finding love. This show is about mess. The single life is about mess for me.
It is about mess. It's a great tell-all. Yeah. There is not a tell-all on this one. So this one just ends.
So the only thing we knew is Michelle shows up and I'm like, her? It's not that she's unattractive. I just thought she would be like some type of bombshell.
You kind of feel like that's what Carlos would go
yeah.
for.
And I went, her?
And
she's perfectly lovely, but she's not like a almost drag queen-esque persona, which I thought he would go for.
This is what I want to say. Did Carlos describe or sell this wrong to Valentine? Because listening to Michelle talk about this, she was like, yeah, you said you were into me, but I'm in a relationship and have a boyfriend and I'm not into you. I already have a boyfriend. It almost literally reminded me of when you're in middle school and someone says, hey, Becky, I have a crush on you. She's like, well, I don't think of you that way. Let's be friends. And you go, okay. Like, that's the way she described this. Like, this was not a big deal. Whereas Carlos acted like, to me...
I told her.
I confessed my passion to her.
That I had feelings for her, and she said it was not reciprocal, but I want her to come to my wedding because she's my best friend.
And yes, and I don't know, he just, was it me or my remembering, or did he act like it was
well
almost
what,
more potentially consensual?
Here's the problem. When he talked about it with Valentine says that he was emotionally unfaithful. That's what Carlos was.
Which, technically, I guess, if you're with someone and you say, hey, I'm into you, I know this isn't by poodle standards, but if you say I'm into you, you want to fuck, that's a Tuesday for you.
Yeah.
But that is cheating.
It's cheating. I think
emotional stuff is harder, though. And I think, y'all, this is the thing. We talked about this on our call server with Cray Cray. I think everyone gets, if there's a question about who to invite to a wedding, everyone gets a veto. Everyone gets one or two vetoes.
Yeah, because Carla says, well, if she can't come, then none of your friends can come.
No, it doesn't work that way. You get one veto and then one veto.
Guess what?
Or two and two.
Michelle doesn't want to come to your wedding anyway. Because why, Poodle? I literally set you up the way you set me. Well, we both dropped the ball.
What is it? Oh, because no one wants to come to your fucking wedding.
No one wants to come to your fucking
wedding. And I guarantee you, this wedding's going to be lame.
I don't think it's going to happen.
Yeah, I agree. And so she went, so I ruined a wedding? So I did it?
Ugh.
She said, but I feel guilty. I find this story is just like cruising to a crushing halt. I
They're
find,
breaking up.
Yeah. Good. Let's go to the biggest.
Valentine, I'm in LA.
Let's go to the biggest non-story, which I actually feel offended I have to still watch.
I think it's all for audacity.
Yeah.
I will say.
Jordan and Everton.
Jordan behaves, it acts the best of anybody we've seen in a long time on 90 Day Fiancé visiting someone's parent in a country where
it's not April.
It's not April. It's not Danielle even.
That's true.
It's definitely not April. Boy, that looks fucking messy next week. Ooh, messy.
So, he is meeting his mother after 12 years. And I really wish.
Was that long.
Well, no, but I'm saying the reason why it's after 12 years is they haven't really been serious. That's the bottom line.
They've been so. That's why I don't believe. Just jumping ahead, but that's why I don't believe she cares if they get married or
not. No, no.
I actually think they're a couple. I think they love one another.
Yeah,
and I think they're a couple that. Looked and they're fine with it. I actually kind of respect this. They say, hey, you know what? We love each other and we think we can have a good transactional business partnership as well as a couple. That's what this all is about.
I totally agree. And you're right. Jordan does help his mother. And we found out that her mom passed away at 30. And I don't know if I believe this one. She's like, when I started thinking about her mom and his mom and her health, it made me really concerned because I was thinking about my mom. I was like, okay, that's a stretch.
I mean, people do that.
Well, I've never had a parent die, so.
I mean, yes. My ex's my ex's dad kind of meant more to me after my dad died.
Interesting.
I loved his dad. No, but like, I mean, like I bonded with him. So you do bond with the other person's parent when someone dies.
Also, she's wearing a shirt that says gratitude is so gangster.
It is, I guess.
It's just a very strange thing to put on a t-shirt.
It's very, I don't think I would feel comfortable
especially
wearing that
shirt. A white woman.
Yeah.
Being
with spiders on her eyes.
Yes, who's also dating a black man.
I wouldn't wear it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't wear it.
It made me a little insecure.
Yeah.
As we move on.
Like, I wouldn't wear a shirt that said straight out of therapy. Although I kind of want that shirt now. Y'all, because God wants you to go to therapy.
God wants you to go to therapy.
Yes.
Not like God wants. Who was it who was talking about God wants me? Oh, Amanda. Poor Amanda and Rosmond.
Amanda and Rosmond.
You don't know what that's from. B90.
Oh, B90. Sorry, we just had it. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
When she said, God wants me to find another man for a stepfather of my child. No, God wants you to go to therapy, honey. Or at least to go to your church counselor even.
Well,
sometimes
they can tell you God wants that, but usually they're.
But at least it's searching. At least it's seeking out help.
Seeking help, yeah,
yeah. Because that's sometimes the first people won't go to a therapist, but they'll go see a counselor. Again, I'm not suggesting.
Pastor Tim.
I'm not saying one of the, but at least you're actually talking with someone
else. If
you're
a really great pastor or a priest or whatever, it can be really helpful.
And I'm sure there are
Father Flushit. We weren't going to ask him shit.
Father Flushit.
Well, his name was Flushay, but we called him Flushit because he was terrible. He was out of touch because they have these like 90-year-old
So you could have
gay priest.
You could have went to him and saying, "I'm having questions about my sexuality." And what would he say?
Oh, I confessed once and said I'd done something with the man, and he didn't miss a beat. He said, "You're forgiven," and just put the communion on my tongue and have me drink the wine.
It's that easy, huh?
I felt better, and then 2 days later, I fucked around with
you
the guy.
You did it again.
Yeah.
You know, I never had...
Went to a lot of confessions before I came out.
I never had that guilt.
Oh, I thought about never going had into the priesthood.
Wow.
I actually thought about it for a good solid 3 months. I thought I was going to leave college and go into the priesthood.
What?
Yeah, I really considered it. I was a pretty devout Catholic.
You would have been a terrible priest.
I would have been really good, I think, except for the fact that I want to fuck men.
Except for the celibacy part.
I'm a good community leader. We would have done fun things. I would have gotten along with the Knights of Columbus, drinking beer, and then the ladies, whenever we could do knitting circles. I think I would have been great.
Father Faggot.
Yeah,
Father Faggot
please.
Mysteries. Anyway.
Indomine Sacco.
We need to move on before we offend everyone. So he basically says, getting married is not in my head right now. And her face is like, whoa. And the caterpillars are getting angrier.
The spiders are going.
And y'all, so she kind of lights into him about kind of like blowing off marriage.
His brother's high as fuck, right?
Yeah, yeah. The whole family looked like they were high.
His brother's just like, whatever.
And at one point, and I wrote down, they might have a foundation to own a business together, but they don't have a foundation of trust to get married yet. Neither one of these people think that.
They do. They don't want to get married.
Yeah. I think this is for audacity. And
I think they're fine. Y'all, when your girlfriend says, hey, I sit on cakes and get icing in my poo nanny for money online, and you go, gotta do what you gotta do. Not a lot of things surprise you. You're not upset about getting married.
And he's like, yeah, then she made me a video and I'm fine.
And it makes you a video and you're fine. When you say, you know what? My boyfriend of 12 years cheated on me with this other woman who bitch called me the day I landed. But you know what?
All in
it's
a day.
It's fine. You don't fucking care about getting married.
That's why this had me going, okay, I officially don't care anymore.
No.
Yeah. The stakes aren't high for me anymore.
If something like they were like in this open type of relationship and then one of them had feelings for like a third party, that would be interesting.
That's real too. Yeah.
That's one thing that is sometimes I think limit stories of 90 Day Fiancé because it's mainly a show that people watch in America.
Yeah.
And a lot of people that aren't from as progressive places that they have to put a lot of these couples in this binary of will they or won't they? And sometimes it just doesn't fit.
A binary creates stakes. Yeah. And it is having a third option does lower your stakes. Yeah.
Unless you're Carlentine.
That's true. Well, honestly, for them, it did. As soon as they, which y'all, here's the thing. They definitely have an open relationship when they're flying back. Valentine needs to get his dick wet, and probably so is Carlos.
Yeah.
So let me disabuse you of that notion right away. They definitely have an open relationship when either is out of the country.
Yeah.
So don't start that ruins. Sorry, Carl's wife, but that ruins the stakes for you.
I think Carl's wife was fine.
I think that's the show. Carlentine, Carlentine, what you're gonna be my Carlentine, Model T, Carlentine. Oh, here's the jug solo.
Y'all come back now.
Yeah.